Oh, I never would have thought we'd start training camp in China.
I think Brad slept 15 hours straight. If he said anything else, he's lying.
Welcome to China!
I love this. It was definitely worth the trek.
It is the 2018 ORG NHL China Games.
Fighting strap tied up just in case.
Oh!
What? That can't be a fish.
One of those things that you'll remember for the rest of your life. A lot of stories to tell when you get back.
The National Hockey League and the National Hockey League Players Association are excited to be coming back to China. We're returning to Beijing, and now we're bringing the 2018 ORG China Games to Shenzhen for the very first time.
Anytime we play hockey, it takes you to different parts of the world, usually the States or Canada, but I was obviously excited.
For the second straight year, the ORG NHL China Games will be played in the world's most populous nation, entertaining a new audience as the curtain opens on the 2018-19 season.
For me, going on a new team, it's a good chance for me to get to know the guys.
This is big for team bonding. I think anytime you can get your team together for 9 days, it's important because we have a lot of new faces around our team this year and a new coaching staff.
This is a unique experience, and if you come here with an open mind and enjoy that all that's out there and all there is to see, then I think that the players would be better off for it, and the coaches for that matter.
Ready to go. Get me on the plane already.
Although the journey ahead of them was a long one, the two teams would be traveling in style and ultimate comfort to China.
Joined by Johnny Gaudreau here on the AirX charter to China. And look at this. I thought they were going to get you.
They were coming in. I just was waiting for it. I didn't realize it was going to be this soon into the interview.
What are you going to do to kind of make the time pass?
By recommendations from our training staff, get a little sleep in.
Enjoy the flight. We'll check in like 7 hours and see how you're holding up.
Perfect. I'll probably be sleeping, so just wake me up.
This is a long flight. I don't know if you've heard this, but we're talking 14 hours.
Is it? Oh, I thought we were almost there.
Yeah.
Where are the hot plates?
There's plenty of buttons.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah, the flight was incredible. Very rare that you get to travel like that.
This is no banter, really.
Stuck down here.
Well, that's pretty flat.
Seat warmers? No, I'm just kidding.
Just hang out with the guys and play a little bit cards, you know, and get some sleep.
I think I slept probably about 12 hours, maybe 13.
I think Brad slept like 15 hours straight, and if he said anything else, he's lying.
As China eagerly awaited the arrival of the teams, two of hockey's greatest ambassadors were already on the ground, solidifying the foundation for the growth of the sport.
First time in China, so very special, very heartwarming for us. We're here at the rink, and it's been a lot of fun. This is the 27th country we've been in. For the people here, it's been very special, a lot of smiles, I think a lot of memories as well.
You know, we're just trying to give hockey a little bit of a jump start, a little bit of a boost. The game is a great game, and once people get a chance to play it and see it, it's going to grow on its own. Hockey seems to be on the rise, and that's great for everyone.
With the excitement of the China Games building, sport's most iconic trophy met the nation's most iconic landmark. The Great Wall.
Years ago, you would never have thought that hockey would be existing in China. Here we are today with the Stanley Cup. We have the NHL China Games going on. It's a check mark on the bucket list for Stanley Cup.
Located on China's southern coast, just north of Hong Kong, Shenzhen welcomed the Bruins in flames. Home to the world's fourth tallest building.
Holy, this thing's massive.
Shenzhen has transformed from a fishing village of 50,000 people in 1980 to a metropolis with a population of over 12 million.
Definitely different from where I grew up. People were friendly to us, though. It was hard to communicate with them, but they did their best.
In a country with so much to explore, the players' focus remains on hockey as training camps open, signifying the official start of the new season.
I think it's an exciting time to get back on the ice and share with your teammates that you're going to battle with throughout a season.
A lot of hours in the air and on the bus, and we spent lots of time with each other hanging out here, so it's good to get on the ice, get a feel for each other.
The Flames were especially eager, skating for the first time with their new head coach, Bill Peters.
It was a good first few days here. It's been up-tempo. We're trying to get used to his style, obviously, his style of practice, his style of coaching. It's been a cool experience.
Following Calgary's skate, the Bruins held their first practice of the season.
I never would have thought we'd start training camp in China, of all places, but it's a beautiful part of the world. We've got six new faces with us, so integrating with some of the veteran guys, how things are done the Bruins way, and same token, just getting to know one another away from hockey.
It's a little bit different, but, you know, great experience for guys who is here. And every practice, just, you know, focus, get ready for the season.
It is the 2018 ORG NHL China Games from Shenzhen. Today's preseason battle between the Boston Bruins and the Calgary Flames, first of two games in China. We're underway in Shenzhen.
Lots of time, lots. Scoot.
We got a ton of new faces, new coaching staff. So for us, we're learning our systems. We're learning a lot about each other, tendencies. We got a lot of work to do, but it's good. So we'll put it in and get ready for the first game of the year.
Bruins chip it in. It's a 2-on-1. Frederick scores! Trent Frederick, 20-year-old, opens the scoring with 6:18 to go in the first period.
Preseason hockey, I guess, is pretty good for, you know, the growth of the game because it's kind of scrambling. There's going to be lots of things that happen out there.
Fields pass intercepted. It's a 2-on-1 for the Bruins. Donato scores! What a shot by Ryan Donato, and it's 2-0 Boston.
Good shot. It's my bad. I got to get over there quicker.
It's fun to be a part of, and we're also trying to make it as entertaining as possible as well.
攻出来了，哎，好球！打板，进了四点六，哇！The defenseman John Moore makes it 3-0 Bruins.
Good job, boys. Nice play.
Came down 3-0 early in the first period. Didn't sit well with us.
Let's have a shift. Come on.
Time ticks down. Flames get it out front. Line and scores. As time winds down on the first, the Flames are on the board.
Had a big goal there by Monty and kind of got us going there for the second and third.
Come on, boys, that big second. Let's go.
Kind of picked up a little bit as it went on.
Leave it.
A little more intense. Guys started to play to win a little bit, and with the competitive nature, it started to ramp up a bit.
Scrambled the side of the Calgary crease. A little pushing and shoving for the first time after the whistle. That'll do it. The second period is in the books, and it ends the same way the first did, with the Bruins up 3-1.
No one likes to lose. I think all the guys, their competitiveness came out.
Fighting strap tied up, just in case.
Here's Johnny Gaudreau in with Monahan. Gaudreau off the boards, out front with a pass, to score! Mark Giordano on the back door, set up by Gaudreau, and it's a one-goal game.
I didn't think he was going to pass him.
Yeah, a little bit chippy out there. A little bit of things you don't usually see in exhibitions.
Bouncing puck gathered in, and Yaroslav makes it on a couple of saves with 2:08 to go in regulation time.
Number 42, Boston.
Nathan Backes is going to the penalty roughing box. 2 minutes for roughing.
Minor on sportsmanlike conduct, Boston bench.
They're going to give them a bench minor.
A full 2 minute, two-man advantage for Calgary.
Johnny, I'll switch to my one-timer. 5-on-3.
Johnny Gaudreau racing to the play. Back to Brody. Over to Giordano with a one-timer. Scores! Mark Giordano, second of the game. And the Flames tie it at 3.
There was a call in front of our net, a late call. Gave the fans an exciting finish. Got some overtime, got to a shootout.
There's Matthew Tkachuk. He will shoot first for the Calgary Flames. Looking to score here to open the shootout, and does. What a move. Goes backhand, top shelf.
Jake DeBrusk can win it for the Bruins. Scores! And the Bruins knock off Calgary in a shootout 4-3 in the first game of this two-game series in China.
After treating the fans in Shenzhen to an extraordinary display, Boston and Calgary were set to showcase their talents in the country's capital. Beijing, the capital of the People's Republic of China, is home to over 21 million people and will play host for the second of the two China Games. On an off day, Michael Backlund and his Flames teammates decide to explore the city, if they can only get a cab first.
Taxi?
Yeah. Police?
No, that's a cop.
Yeah! Hey! Yeehaw! Yep. Yep.
So I assume that's the Forbidden City. Tiananmen Square was really cool. I brought the dream team with me too, a good crew. It's always cool to go to historical places. A long way back in the history, so it's pretty cool.
While Backlund and company tour Beijing, Mark Giordano and Sean Monahan sample the local fare.
Right here.
Yeah, it smells good.
Is there a special way that we're supposed to drink this?
Really good.
It tastes great.
While the Flames enjoy their tea, the Bruins head to the mall.
Shopping today, Pluto.
It's pretty unique in that aspect. I think that's what we all kind of took it as an opportunity to enjoy, you know, things like that off the ice. I think that's the biggest thing. And obviously, it's still training camp, but you try to, you know, bond as much as possible and take in as much experience as you can. I think that lots of guys, this might be their only time coming to China, maybe not, but you never really know. You never know that you're gonna go or not go. So we're taking it in stride and trying to learn as much as possible.
Both teams cap off their experience with a once-in-a-lifetime trip to the Great Wall of China, where the Calgary Flames begin with some souvenir shopping.
How do these shades look? I just bought them.
Look good.
They got a Burger King here?
Awesome. Cool, try and a hat.
You want me to give you one?
Let's go.
I need some help. She started at 350, so I think you did okay.
I have no more yarn.
No, I bought two already.
No, thank you. Jushia. American. How much?
How much for this? 20. 20?
I think it's just a day for guys just to just be loose. Not worry about hockey, not worry about anything. Just kind of enjoy what we were doing, enjoy being here, and just have some fun with each other. So, you know, it's a two-hour bus ride there, so we'd hang out, and just the whole day was, you know, it went really smoothly.
50, there we go.
Got everything in sight.
I think I spent all my money at the Great Wall of China. So I had a panda bear hat, I had a robe, I had just about everything.
Can you wear my hat for me for a bit?
Hold on. Perfect.
I hope so, man.
This
isn't that high. You think we can make this swing?
No, just don't do that.
Dude,
I'm
stop.
Gonna
panic,
dude.
I'm gonna have a full panic, dude.
Hey, buddy. Welcome to China.
Imagine if you drop your passport right now. How peaceful is this?
Hey, look, we got a group photo.
Hey, how much?
Sorry, mom.
No.
For the photo?
It's just kind of the whole experience. I mean, it's a different culture. I mean, we've experienced a lot of things going to the Great Wall. I think it's kind of one of those things that you'll remember for the rest of your life.
Without hockey, I would have never visited any of these places. So we take that into perspective and appreciate it for sure.
That a boy, Schneid. Did you carry that up on the gondola?
They delivered up to the
Schneid. Schneid's the delivery man. Absolute legend.
A lot of meat in the screen.
Someone your age should be taking the footpath, I think, sir.
Did they ask you if you'd be down to get carried up a little bit? This is not good. I was freaking out up there, man. And it was windy, too. I literally was holding on for my life. Pasta and JP were like, yeah. I was like, oh, my God. Really scared there. Afraid of heights, so that was tough. Nice to get out alive, that's for sure. This is unreal.
I love this. It was definitely worth the trek up here. But look at this. This is so cool. This is awesome.
Take advantage of it while you can, right?
No, it's good.
It's really good. Good day for the fellas. Get back to work tomorrow, right?
It's pretty incredible to see the Great Wall, to really experience in person. It's a place I'd always dreamed of going to. But to actually be there and see how magnificent it is, it's definitely something you want to see.
I never thought I would honestly go to the Great Wall or anything like that, but I knew it was what it was in a sense, but I didn't understand how big it was or how long it was. It was a pretty good workout.
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, obviously it's something new, and the training camp is about fighting for a spot and all of that, but at the same time, you have to become a group, you know. Hockey is a team sport, so you have to become a good group and play as a one man, you know, and this is a good opportunity for us to become close to each other, and hopefully it's gonna help us.
Look at that.
And this is how we're getting down right here. A little slide. I'll be sliding down that wall.
The grandiose scale of the wall and all the man hours and work that went into building, you know, even a mile of that thing, I can't imagine. So it's certainly spectacular. Reading the sign on the bottom, it said it was originally built to defend them, and now it brings the world together for people and tourists and visitors to come together and see the site that was built here. Certainly a marvel to be seen.
Before Game 2, Derek Dunn, a native Canadian playing professional hockey in China for KRS-ORG Beijing of the VHL, received the opportunity of a lifetime.
On behalf of the Boston Bruins, we're excited to have Derek sign a professional tryout to be our emergency goaltender.
Both my grandparents are from China. This is my second year playing professional out here. Culturally, it's a lot different than North America, but now I'm fully immersed in Chinese culture, and I've embraced it.
Shot. Not go in.
Hopefully you don't play. That means that the goalie got hurt, but we welcome you to the Boston Bruins.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right. Thank you.
While Dunn was just happy to be at camp, for Bruins prospects Jack Studnicka and Trent Frederick, the trip to Beijing was an opportunity to meet potential teammates and make an impression on Boston's coaching staff.
Yeah, this is my second training camp, so this time around it's pretty surreal being in China. You know, last year training camp, you kind of just see the guys at the rink for 2 or 3 hours a day, and here you're together basically 24/7. A lot of us are experiencing this country for the first time, so it's good to see how other people around the world get to live. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I wonder what kind of fish they're catching here.
Are we gonna try to catch some fish?
This guy's gonna let us use it? Over. Oh, wow. That is right where you pointed. I'm expecting a fish. You wanna try, Freddy?
I guess I'm throwing this one.
Oh, you got one too?
We're not getting much respect from the other fishermen. They're kind of chuckling over there.
Oh!
What?
Yeah, let me reel that in.
That can't be a fish.
We got a bag.
At least we caught something. Can you grab this for me?
You want me to?
I can't grab it, I have to hold it.
Yeah, we got some seaweed.
Thanks, man.
Yep.
Yeah, no fish are biting here.
I think that bag and that seaweed is...
That's our treasures today.
Yeah, that might be it.
Sorry, we're not very good fishermen.
Oh, it's yours? All right.
Thank you. Shia, shia.
Is it getting any bites?
Oh, there it is. Can we pretend like we caught those?
Well, there's times this trip's a vacation, and there's times it's a business trip, and we have the same goals of making the big team. And I think if we just work hard and put our heads down and learn from these guys, we'll get a lot out of it.
The NHL China Games draw to a close in Beijing with the second battle between the Boston Bruins and the Calgary Flames.
Pace, play with pace, on pucks, hunt pucks, all right? Let's go win the first period, man.
Let's go, man, hey?
Great crowd in this building, Cadillac Arena. Second year that Beijing has hosted NHL preseason games, and fans here are loving it.
There's lots of people out there that are getting new to the game and trying to understand what's going on.
I was part of the first NBA games that came here to China. And now we have in China more people that play basketball than we have in our entire country.
And we are off in Beijing.
It's going to take time for the NHL to build that brand up to that level, but this is a great market for them to be in.
You can already tell the pace is a little bit quicker than it was Saturday afternoon.
Build it, build it, scoot!
people that don't know a lot about hockey and haven't seen a game live, once they do, you know, they appreciate it.
Obviously, every country is different. But it's fun to see how the fans react.
Heads up!
They support us pretty well, cheered for both teams at different times of the game.
They get excited, whether it's a nice move, a hit, or a shot on net, whatever it is, the crowd gets going.
Good hit, Blues. Good hit, Laser. Good hit.
Seems like they really like when we hit each other, so.
That's it, JD. Nice shot, nice shot. Nice pass.
DeBrusk with the goal. The Bruins have a 1-0 lead.
Let's go, let's get one here.
Second period underway.
Go, 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 go.
And now a break here at the end of the period, and Monahan puts it in. And the Calgary Flames and Boston Bruins are all tied up.
Your team get 2 points in this scenario. What's the scenario? You're tied with 20 minutes to go. That's what we're going to do right here.
Enough. It's enough. Let's go.
1-1 Bruins Flames as we get set for the third period. Drop pass to Neal, back to Gaudreau. Gaudreau trying to tuck it in. Last save.
A little quicker pace, we'll be fine. There we go. Go, go.
Flipped off the side of the Calgary net. His second of the game. He tucks it in at a sharp angle. Boston back ahead. 3.5 minutes to go on the third. The Flames down a goal.
Come on, Smitty.
Goalie will be out. He's smart.
Six attackers for the Flames.
Hey, we got to cash in here, man.
80 seconds on the clock.
Go, 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 go.
There's Miller. He'll shoot for the empty net. And he finds it from his own end of the ice. And that will do it. Boston Bruins take both games in the 2018 ORG NHL China Game Series. 3-1 a regulation time victory here in Beijing.
It's an incredible experience.
Mission accomplished for both teams. Both of them were looking at this as a great opportunity to do some bonding and form some chemistry.
Experiences that we had together and how much fun we had, you know, those are things that help us build together as a group throughout the year.
As the players travel back to North America with a lifetime of memories, their influence on hockey in China leaves an indelible impression.
It's good that we get to do this. For us, we love it. It's a great experience. And for us to interact with fans and grow the game internationally, see what we're all about.
We want to see our game grow. That's what we're here to do, is showcase the NHL and the sport. And hopefully it takes off over here and we continue to build on in the future.